fucking lord of the dance. Now, I'm particularly pleased. You know, you always expect the fucks at the front to be losing their mind. And you are disappointed once in a while when you see a dead person somehow slipped in, got through the fucking asshole detector. You see them there and you go, why the fuck make it down the pit, huh? But when I look in the back, and I see happy, sick, demented faces with their fists raised high, singing along, clapping, cheering, it's like, even the handicapped in this town, they're fucking into it too. Can't stand, they can't walk, they're fucking handicapped, and you gotta love them for wheeling their asses down here, getting into it, I'm loving it about you. Especially you in the balcony up there. What's going on with me, because this is my fucking show. So I told you we got a movie coming out. Those of you that remember from the Stay Hungry album, the songs, The Hard Interior, Captain Howdy, and Street Justice. Well, I wrote that, I turned that into a movie. Remember it said at the beginning? Well, I wrote a screenplay, and I got the people who made Sleep Blade to make the movie, starring yours fucking truly as Captain Howdy. Schizophrenic sexual sadist who's into the world of body modification. I promise you, when you see this movie, you'll go, fucking dude. He's more fucked up than that. Here he thought he'd start bellowing with age, but no. Look at the fucker. He's wearing a loincloth, he's tattooed and pierced, and he's torturing people. God love him. That movie will be out next year, they're editing it right now, and there's going to be probably a Strangeland tour, which will be an interesting thing going with that too. Anyway, what else am I up to? Oh, well, there's a TV show they're working on about me, God only knows why. I got a radio show, a syndicated radio show, called Dee Snider's House of Hair. It's an 80s retro show, it's nationally syndicated. I don't know if they have it in this area, but call your radio station and say, hey yo, I want fucking Dee's show. I want fucking Dee Snider's House of Fucking Hair! No! 2 hours, ladies, and that's all. You know, so, it's good. But I told you we'd be playing stuff from all the albums. We're gonna do a few things for you right now. Off the Come Out and Play records. It is this.
Thank you.
from Come Out Play. I know many of you have a very hard time finding Twisted Sister CDs and whatnot. All I got is available is maybe that Best of Twisted and maybe the Stay Hungry album. But I got good news. Got a lot of good news. Me and the Twisted guys, we've been talking again. We were like fucking enemies for like 10 years, and finally we got together and we decided, let's act for sure. We beat the shit out of each other and we became friends. So what we've done is we've gotten back old masters for all of our albums and all of our videos. And right now we're in the process of doing a new deal, so we're gonna make all those records available to the public again. Turns out there's all kinds of things that I forgot about, like two songs on the Stay Hungry album that were never released, which are probably coming out. In the meantime, we have been, my company has been importing records from over in Europe where they have fucking tasted rock and roll, and they do have the Twisted Sister records, and most of them are available somewhere on a merchandise table, or you can do a mail order thing or what have you, regular price, no bullshit, right? And speaking of Twisted and me, well, oh, by the way, we got together, the SMS were playing in New York, and the band came out, Twisted Sister, for the first time in 10 years, got on stage together. We played Under the Blade, we played You Can't Stop Rock and Roll, we played I Wanna Rock, and we played SMF. First time in 10 years, and it felt fucking nice, you know? So, we decided, we know that we're going to do something in the future. We're going to get back together, we're going to play, I think you'll be seeing the band in 1998. And I'll tell you this right now, I see a lot of bands getting together, going out there, and they're trying to prove that they're a fucking 90s band. They're a new band. They're leaving the 80s behind. Yo, if you do a fucking reunion, and you're playing for your fucking fans, you give them what they want to see, do it the way Kiss do it, okay? Full makeup, full costumes, full fucking hair, the platform, the whole fucking not yours, baby! Jeez! Alright, so no plans right now, but it looks like we're gonna do something. But in the meantime, you got me and the sick motherfuckers! I'm feeling pretty laid back tonight. I gotta apologize for the melodies on these songs because I'm fucking... I said, well, I'd rather move around more and be less accurate. All right, this is, this was one of Twisted's favorite songs. It may not be one of yours, but anybody who's got any kind of a dream and been fighting, whether it's in music, or it's in art, or it's in movies, or it's fucking just a regular day job and you're trying to get fucking up, you know what I'm talking about? This one's for you. It's from the You Can't Stop Rock and Roll record. It's called We're Gonna Make It.
I'm going
was fun. That was fun. My favorite thing about that song is you get some of these very dead motherfuckers who absolutely, in their mind, they have said, no way am I fucking doing anything tonight. I don't care if I look like I got a broomstick up my fucking ass. I am gonna stand here like a dick all night long. And then I play that song, and I see what it is. What the fuck, little mouth? They get up, just fly out. Let it go, baby! Let it go! Don't be an asshole your whole life! I'm Dee Snider, and I got the cure for acute assholeitis. First thing you do is bend them over and pull the broomstick out of the rectum. Throw the smelly thing away. And then you're fucking just start doing what you want, when you want, how you want, whatever the fuck you want, and you don't give a shit about what other people are thinking, get it? It's very easy. It's very easy. There's a word for people like that. There's a term for people like that. They're called sick motherfuckers.
Thank you.
see what there's a few to break the crowd. Go to the lights and see what's going on out here. Can I see you? Where are my friends tonight, my friends? I can see you in the dark waving your hands righteously. And you other people are idiots. I mean, it is fucking Wednesday, and you're here watching me jump around like an asshole. So why exactly are you here if you're not a fucked up motherfucker like the rest of these people? I was very impressed with this place. 24 hours. You know, I mean, it's sometimes fucking, you know, 8 a.m., you need a cold one. And you know you can just fucking tool on down here to Pops, and they'll set you up righteously. That's beautiful. I must admit, I was cracking with tears. Okay, if the boys are all ready, we got the song that's not a Twisted song, but Twisted used to finish all of our shows with it. For years, we finished our shows with it. And it doesn't bear any resemblance to the original. And I'm proud to say that Mick Jagger once came down to our show, saw us playing this song, and ran out and threw up in the street. So I felt pretty good about that. I don't know about anybody else. Anyway, here we go. This is called, ready boys? It's only rock and roll, but I like it!
Stop! 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 St
with one fucking thing. I'm not sure what that is, but it's one, and it's up to one thing. I should not have to coax. I should not have to push, pry, urge. What's that word you want me to use tonight? Coagulate. I should not have any trouble getting you motherfuckers a shot. I like it. Let's try it one time. Let's say that no, it's only Rocky Brother. As I suspected. No problem. Let's try it again. I said, I know, it's only rock and roll. Well, we got 90% of the people shouting. We got 10% of the people standing with their dicks in their hands. And my decision as a mature adult, and I am technically a mature adult, should I focus on the negative, berate and harass the assholes and idiots who are standing still and not doing anything? Or should I focus on the positive, the 90% who are mocking and kicking ass and having a good fucking time? You're in luck, assholes! 10 years ago, I would have spent my fucking life focusing on you, but not anymore. So everybody can see where the really righteous motherfuckers in this room are, right? Throw your fist in the air when you yell, I like it. This is it, baby. This is it. This is what we got. Boys. And he kept fucking playing. And that was the magic of Eddie Fingers on Jada. He was an idiot. No, I'm only kidding. I love him. Seriously. Okay, now, this one here, talk about songs that mean something. To me personally, this one means more today than it meant when I wrote it in the first place, and I hope it's the kind of song that means something to you too. This one is called The Price. Playing for the last 3 years. I can't believe it's been 3 years. And we don't play all that much, But every now and then I call him up and I say, hey guys, I just gotta go out, I gotta do some shows, I gotta kick some ass, I gotta get on the stage, I gotta play some fucking music, bang my head righteously. Can you come with me? And they always do. They always manage to come. They drop in the door and they go, yeah, Dee, we're with you, baby! Back in the van. So please, start over on that side of the stage. On the lead guitar, a round of applause to Tony Palamucci over there. Some of you may have seen this guy in the movie The Exorcist. He was the stomach for Linda Blair in the Help Me scene. Going way back. On the bass guitar, please a round of applause, Derek Taylor! Sick motherfucker in the back, kicking me in the ass. I think he's doing the same for you. On the drums, Charlie Mills, everybody! And over here, the big man on this side of the stage, this guy's a professional body piercer for a living. When I found him, it was in a piercing shop called the Gauntlet. He was putting a fucking needle through a woman's clitoris. And I was so impressed with that, I said, I hope you play an instrument, because you gotta be in my band. Just so happens that he played guitar. Thank God, it would have been embarrassing having a guy standing on the stage. Anyway, please a round of applause for Keith Alexander! He'll be piercing clitorises after the show. Okay, are we ready? This is sort of the song, you know, we end all the shows with because, well, it just makes sense, damn it. This one is from me to you, because remember what I always say, once an SMF, always an SMF. This is SMF!
I'm not going to